Thank you, Gupta sir. Thanks sir for waiting. Thanks to all of you for waiting for so long, and still you are here when all were leaving one by one. So, but anyway, I will talk as I am part of the State E-Governance Mission team for the National E-Governance Plan in Government of Gujarat at here. And I am new to this state, but I will speak about actually what actually we are going to for the future, what we have in our basket, and exactly I will talk on 5-6 points for 2-3 minutes time, so that you can know that where actually we are moving forward in this thing. We all understood from the past presenter that we have crossed the transformation stage, means we have seen 4 presentations from the eminent speakers, secretaries, department, and they have done ample work in their departments. It means we have crossed the transformation stage. But challenge is with convergence. Convergence means joined up government. Finally, we have to bring all the departments together so that finally citizen will understand single government. And here is the challenge. So we are moving towards the convergence. We are planning for the convergence. And for that, we are planning state data structure so that we can release to all the departments, common state data structure so that all the future applications will use that and take it forward. Means we want to bring the reusability component across all. Meaning, if some department is developing the human resource application, then other department should not develop the same framework, they should reuse it. And slowly we are trying to move towards the convergence. So one first point is the convergence. Second point, which is very also important. Now we want to come out with the online submission of forms and that complete delivery cycle. Here, there are 2 approaches. One is that each service is one system. And if we have 150 services, it means 150 systems. Or some sort of e-forms and that kind of things. Second approach is which we are adopting, that is the non-programmatic approach for developing e-forms. Means we will not develop individual applications, individual services for the citizens. Instead of state-wide, we will plan the state engine. Means we will take some more time to construct that form generator. And the moment we are ready, it will be very easy for us to build one by one services and we will take it forward. Second part is over. That is the submission and building up the services. Third component, we are now giving us ample thrust for the mobile governance. And for the m-governance, we will take departments and basic and very easily implementable applications we will come with the m-governance. So m-governance is also on our priority. This is the third point. One Gujarat, from the government point of view, because we have already the GSWAN in our place, means our data infrastructure is already ready up to tehsil level. Now we are coming out with the unified communication, means our tehsil office and all the offices of the government of Gujarat, complete Gujarat will be one PABX for us in simple terms. It's unified communications, all you understand, which we are coming out soon. Social media policy. Yesterday I was with the Union Minister, Mr. Kapil Simbal, and we were deliberating this issue of social media, and a lot of issue we discussed today, you may have seen in the newspaper also. We are coming with the active participation in the social media, means participation through the external websites, external like Facebook, Twitter, and this kind of things, and we will encourage departments to participate through this way. We will come out with the policy soon. after policy of the Government of India, and we will club. We have given them the suggestions. And thereafter, we will plan the one statewide social media platform where other departments will participate. This will be the sixth initiative which we will take from here. We also want to leverage the cloud computing. And within the cloud computing, I want to be freeze. One thing is the software as a service. Here also, we want to encourage the more adoption of the subscription-based software. Yes, definitely from the security purposes, whatever perception is there, we will use state data center. But we will encourage small products to be hosted at the SDC. And as part of the joined up government and the convergence, other departments should use as a subscribe. They should subscribe their software and they should further move fast. So no need of duplications and these kind of things. So software as a subscription, we are taking part of the cloud computing. Yes. We also have plan to build queuing mechanism in our most of the applications. All the citizen-centric places where we already have some transformation, departments have developed fantastic applications, and people are availing the services. Here, as part of the policy, we want to include the queuing mechanism so that people in the queue, and they should maintain discipline and first in, first out kind of thing as a policy we want as part of the convergence. I think this is okay.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. Yeah.